الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على شرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، regarding أحمد الحسن الأشعري رحمه الله تعالى، we mentioned that he went through the three phases of his life. The first he was Mu'tazili under the tutorship of Al-Juba'i, the Mu'tazili of Basra, and then after that he freed himself from that, and then he entered into the second stage of his life, and he became a student and a follower of Ibn Kullab, the one whom Abdullah Ibn Kullab and Shaykh Imam Ahmad Ibn Hanbal, that he made tabdi', and he declared him to be an innovator, and he ordered the people to abandon him and boycott him. And then thereafter that he entered into the third stage of his life, which was the stage that he took on board the aqidah of Imam Ahmad Ibn Hanbal. And we mentioned the statement of the great Imam Shaykh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah in his book Al-Istiqamah, quoting a statement of Abdul Qadir al-Jilani rahimahullah, that Abdul Qadir al-Jilani was asked the question that is it possible for a person to be a wali of Allah, to be a wali from the friends and close allies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be upon an aqidah of, other than the aqidah of Ahmad ibn Hanbal? And Abdul Qadir al-Jilani rahimahullah responded, this has not occurred and it will never occur, that a person to be a wali of Allah and be upon an aqidah other than the aqidah of Ahmad ibn Hanbal, it is not possible. So after that, we mentioned that he wrote some books, Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. And from the books that he wrote, we mentioned Al-Maqalat al-Islamiyyin and Al-Ibana and Usul al-Diyana. And one of the brothers asked, he said that he read something from this Mubtadi', innovator, a caller to misguidance and a da'iyah towards the abwab of Jahannam, or towards the doors and the gates of Jahannam. Nuha min Kalada, he mentioned that this book, so these books, and especially Al-Ibana and Usul al-Diyana of Abu al-Hasan, cannot be attributed to him. And one of the brothers mentioned, is there something from the scholars that they have written with regard to ascribing this book to him? Then we mentioned that, first of all, from those scholars who ascribed this book to him, referring back to those chains of narration and those manuscripts that were with them, that ascribed these books, especially Al-Ibana and Usul al-Diyana, and likewise Al-Maqalat al-Islamiyyin, these are books of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari in which he places his recantation and his tawbah and his tarajuh, his leaving off the bidah that he was upon and returning and going to the sunnah and establishing the aqidah of Ahmad ibn Hanbal. From them we have Ibn Asakir, Al-Hafid ibn Asakir, in his Tabiyyin Kadib al-Muftari, that he establishes that this book, Al-Ibana, is the book of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. And likewise he refutes Al-Ahwazi, who mentioned that the only reason Abu al-Hasan wrote this book was a form of taqiyyah, it was a form of deception, that he was so afraid of the Hanbalis, so afraid of the students of Ahmad ibn Hanbal, that he only wrote this book as a deception to get them off his back. So Ibn Asakir, he discusses in this book, Tabiyyin Kadib al-Muftari, that he mentions that this Al-Ahwazi, that in fact this is a lie and a slander and a curse and a belittlement of this Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, that you would accuse him of writing a book affirming the aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah and Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and claiming and clearly stating that this is the aqidah that I'm upon Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and that he only wrote this as a deception. He said this is far from the qualities, even when Abu al-Hasan was a deviant caller to the ideas of the Mu'tazila, Abu al-Hasan was a truthful deviant, in the sense that he didn't lie, he didn't hide that which he was upon. So when he was a Mu'tazili, he was a straight up, straightforward Mu'tazili. When he was Kullabi, then he was a straight up, straightforward Kullabi with thousands of followers. And when he came to the Sunnah and he left all of that bid'ah, then he was straight up and straightforward, clear upon his truthfulness. Likewise we have Al-Bayhaqi in his Al-I'tiqad. Imam Al-Bayhaqi likewise mentions that this was the aqidah, page 31 of Al-I'tiqad, that this was the aqidah of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, and that he ascribes Al-Ibana and Usul al-Diyana to him. Likewise Imam Al-Dhahabi in Al-Ulu, and likewise Imam Al-Dhahabi in his Sir Alam al-Nubala, under the biography of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, and likewise under the biography of Imam al-Barbahari, that he ascribes the writing of Al-Ibana and other than Al-Ibana
to Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. This is Imam Dhahabi in Al-Ulu, and likewise in Sir Alam al-Nubala. And likewise Ibn al-Imad, or Ibn al-Imad, in Ishadarat al-Dhahab. That likewise he mentions, on page 303, that he mentions that this al-Ibana is ascribable to Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari. And likewise Abu al-Qasim Abdul Malik, famously known as Ibn al-Dabbas from the 5th century, died I think in 579 or thereabouts, that he wrote a book which he entitled Al-Dhab and Abi Hassan Al-Ash'ari. A defense or a protection or a defense of Abu al-Hasan Al-Ash'ari. And in this likewise he ascribes, and then he mentions scholar after scholar after scholar from the Salaf who clearly stated and that he had seen the manuscripts with his own eyes, and those who had seen the manuscripts of the writing of Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, and those who took from Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari in the far-off lands, that they mentioned that these recantations, and these taraju'at, or these recanting and coming back to the truth, that they were clearly established upon the great Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, rahimahullahu ta'ala. And we mentioned more than this yesterday, showing the ikhlas of this great Imam, and the clear cut nature of his recantation, and that this is, if a person wants to make tawbah, this is how you make tawbah. Take the example of Abu al-Hasan, and likewise the example of the great Imam that we mentioned, Nu'aym bin Hammad, that he used to be a Jahmi, and then when he recanted from being a Jahmi, that he wrote somewhere in the region of 13 to 15 books in refutation of the Jahmiyyah. So this is an example of the taraju'at, and likewise the example of the tawbah of the salaf of this ummah with regard to a bid'ah that they were upon, and then they returned to the truth. Jazakallah khair.